What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the previous behavioral interview questions video of the series, we discussed the STAR method and mentioned that STAR stands for situation, task, action, and result. This method is a popular interviewing technique used to answer behavioral interview questions. As a reminder, in the situation part, you should describe the context and background of the story you are telling. In the task part, you should explain the specific task or challenge you were facing. In the action part, you must describe the actions you took to address the situation or task while focusing on the you part of these actions. And finally, in the result, you should explain the outcome or result of your actions. By using the STAR method, you can provide a structured and detailed response that demonstrates your skills and experience in a clear and concise manner. This technique is often used by interviewers to assess a candidate's problem-solving abilities, communication skills, and overall fit for the role. In the second video, we are going to go through a few examples or questions and attempt to solve them using the STAR method from the point of view of a software developer. So, first question, describe a time when you had to work under pressure to meet a deadline. What were the challenges you faced and what was the overall result achieved? A possible answer to this question could be, during my time as a Java software developer in my previous company, I was tasked with completing a project to implement a new functionality within a pre-existing system. The project was on a tight deadline with only 2 weeks to complete the development work before the system was due to be released into production. As the lead developer on the project, my primary responsibility was to ensure that the development team met the deadline and delivered the required functionality to the satisfaction of the stakeholders and the program layer. To meet the deadline, I immediately broke the project down into smaller tasks and assigned each task to a team member based on their skills and experience. I ensured that each task had a clear deadline and that everyone was aware of the timeline we needed to work with. As we progressed through the development work, we encountered several challenges. There were a few technical hurdles to overcome, such as integrating the new functionality within existing code and resolving dormant bugs that arose during testing. Additionally, we had to manage the expectations of stakeholders who had differing opinions on how the new functionality should work. To manage these challenges, I implemented daily stand-up meetings with the team to ensure everyone was aware of the progress, identified roadblocks early, and collaborated on solutions. I also facilitated regular meetings with the stakeholders and the program layer to discuss their concerns, provide updates, and manage expectations. So, despite the challenges we faced, our team delivered the new functionality on time, and the system was released to production as scheduled. The stakeholders were pleased with the outcome, and a couple of days later we started receiving positive feedback on the quality of the work. The success of the project strengthened the team's relationships, built trust with stakeholders, and boosted our confidence in handling future high-pressure projects. Okay, notice how in this answer, the action part was dominant compared to the situation and task parts, and that is a really important point, because that is the part where you get the chance to talk about what you did. And even though this part made it seem like that person did most of the work, in the result part, we went back and praised the whole team. Now let's tackle the second question. Can you describe a time when you had to work with a difficult colleague or team member? How did you handle it? What was the result of your actions? A possible answer could be, during my time as a software developer, I was part of a team that included a colleague who was consistently difficult to work with. This team member had a reputation for being uncooperative, dismissive of others' ideas, and often taking credit for work they hadn't done. My role in the team was to collaborate with that person to develop a new feature for a software application we were working on. It was essential for me to find ways to handle this difficult colleague and work together to complete our tasks within the given timelines. So, I approached the situation by first trying to understand the root causes of the behavior. And after some initial conversations, it became clear that the colleague was feeling undervalued and had been given feedback that they felt was not constructive. To address this issue, I decided to focus on building a more positive relationship with that person. I took the time to listen to their ideas and perspectives and recognize their contribution to the project. Additionally, I tried to be more explicit in giving credit where credit was due and provide specific and factual feedback on how they could improve their work. I also tried to be more proactive in collaborating with them, arranging regular meetings to discuss project progress, any challenges encountered, and ways to improve our work as a team. Through these actions, I was able to manage them effectively, leading to a more productive and positive working relationship. They became more open to feedback and more responsive to suggestions, which improved our collaboration and made it easier to work on tasks together. Also, the project was delivered on time and met all the requirements of the stakeholders. Okay, notice in this answer how we didn't run away from the question, we were straightforward and direct. When asked about colleagues and teammates, do not attempt to lead the conversation to a place in which you feel the need to relay that you loved and were loved by everyone and that you were happy and over the moon, because the interviewer knows that's a lie. Or why are you interviewing in the first place? Instead, be honest and try to convey how you perceived the situation from your own perspective and what are the actions you personally took. Now, let's go through one more question together. Can you describe a time when you collaborated with an outer team to complete a project? How did you handle the communication? What challenges did you face? What were the results achieved? And one possible answer to this question is, in my previous role, I had to collaborate with an external team to complete a project. This team was in a different country and time zone, and we had to work together to ensure the project's success. As a team player, it was essential for me to find ways to manage the situation effectively and ensure that we delivered the project on time with high quality despite the geographical and time differences. To ensure that, I first set up a kickoff meeting to discuss the project's requirements and establish expectations. During the meeting, we identified key milestones and deadlines and assigned specific responsibilities to each team member. Then I established a regular meeting cadence in favor of their time zone to discuss project updates, identify any issues or blockers, and ensure that we were aligned on project direction. Additionally, I set up communication channels through which we could quickly reach out to each other when issues arose or when we needed clarification on requirements. Throughout the project, I always maintained open lines of communication. I was regularly sharing progress updates and discussing issues as they arose. I also held joint code review sessions where we could identify potential issues and provide feedback on each other's work. This allowed us to ensure that the project was completed to a high standard and everyone was satisfied with the outcome. Through effective communication and collaboration, we were able to deliver the project on time and with high quality. We were able to address any issue quickly, and the open lines of communication helped to build trust between both teams. The project was a success, and we received positive feedback from stakeholders. Okay, notice how in this answer we barely dive into the technical details of the actual project because the interviewer did not ask us about that. In the question, they really focus on the communication and collaboration part of the work, and that's what we focused on in our answer. Do not give extra non-needed details, because the more details you provide, the more follow-up questions the interviewer will have. Answer the question. Provide details related to the question itself without deviating from it. So, by following the STAR method, you can provide a clear and concise answer that showcases your skills and experience in a structured manner. And trust me, you will not be able to come up with such structured answers on the fly. You must prepare beforehand. So practice using the STAR method ahead of time so that you're comfortable with it during the interview. Finally, remember the key to using the STAR method is to provide specific details and factual examples related to the question asked that showcase your skills and experience. By doing so, you can demonstrate your value to the interviewer and increase your chances of landing the job. So, that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.